Hello, Scorpio. My name is Agatha, and this is a tarot reading for you and your romantic soulmate. You and your romantic soulmate, what you need to know. I cannot give you timing for this reading. I don't know if this is going to be in a year, in 10 years, in 5 months. I don't even know if this already happened, okay? This is what you need to know about you and your romantic soulmate. I'm going to use the Celtic cross spread, which is a 10 card reading, and I'm going to use for you the Barbieri tarot. Also, this is relevant for those who either have I'm sorry, the sun in Scorpio, the moon in Scorpio, the rising sign in Scorpio, or Venus in Scorpio. I'm sorry, again, apologize. If you'd like something similar for you, I can give you a similar reading just for you about you and your romantic soulmate for about $25, and you can write me to duniazad@gmail.com, and I'd be delighted to work with you. This reading is relevant to you whenever you see it. Whenever you see this reading, it was meant for you to see it at that time. So you can see it now, you can see it 2 years from now, 10 years from now, it doesn't matter because this is a timeless reading, so you can it's relevant for you at the time that you'll see it. Also, please be patient because I'm doing this little by little, and eventually all the sun signs will be up in my YouTube channel. And finally, Scorpio, I'm going to show you three cards, and I'm going to ask you to pick one symbol, and at the end of the reading, I will tell you the meaning of that symbol. The symbols are horse, I'm sorry, not horse, the rider, it's the rider, the child, or letter. So, the rider, child, or letter. Okay, pick one of these symbols, and at the end of the reading, I will tell you the meaning of the card which you have picked. Now let's see, Scorpio, you and your romantic soulmates, what you need to know about you and your romantic soulmates, what you need to know, Scorpio, 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 you need to know about you and your romantic soulmate. So, I'm gonna cut one, two, and finally three. So let's see. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and 10. So let's see you and your romantic soulmate. Four of swords, one. Okay, how many major arcana cards do you have? You have one. It's interesting. You have the judgment card in the last reading. Libra also has the judgment card, but in a different position. You have temperance. You have the sun, which is amazing, and you have the chariot. So, Scorpio, this could be a very again, I'm sorry, a very successful type of relationship for you, more or less at the time when you are at crossroads in your life, when there's some sort of big transformation in your life. This is a time when your soulmate may appear, and you might have a very good, fulfilling, happy, successful type of relationship. The reading that I did before, which was for Libra, that reading, I didn't think that their soulmate, Libra's soulmate, they were not going to be together. But in your case, Scorpio, I think you're going to be together. Okay? That's what I think. I think you're going to have a good relationship and you're going to be together. So, Let's start. The general theme, you have the four swords. And it's interesting, it's an angel, and this angel is putting a sword up, and it's like it's a woman here, and it's she's defending herself. Usually the four of swords connects with retreat, resting, recuperating, and I feel, okay, this is the four of wands. I feel some of you might be recuperating from a previous bad relationship, and now you're kind of on the defense, like, don't bother me, don't mess with me, don't even come near me, I will cut you, metaphorically speaking. So just, let's see, yeah, she's mad, I don't know if you can see it, she's mad, she's looking at us, she's looking at you, and she's mad, like, don't come near me, yeah, she's like, almost defeated. She's resting, but she's mad. She's mad because things did not turn out the way she thought that they would be. And now she feels the need to defend herself. So this is like the general energy when you come in. When at the time, I would say more or less. Or the type of energy that you, Scorpio, might have more or less when you meet your soulmate. Okay? So either you have this energy of don't come near me, I will hurt you, don't come near me, or your soulmate might have this type of energy. So he or she might have this type of energy, like a defensive type of energy. And I'm reading mainly from the image that I'm seeing in this card in particular. Like, she's mad, don't come near me, she's mad, don't. You might be behaving like this, or the other person might be behaving like this. Now, that which is yet not seen. You have the Nine of Cups, which is the wish fulfillment card. Also, this card is connected with, you know, lust and giving into your lust and having a good time, having good lustful times. By the way, the outcome is the Chariot and the Chariot also speaks of a good, let's say, physical type of relationship, and the person with whom you might have this good physical relationship might have something in Cancer, in the sign of Cancer. Why do I say this? Because the last card is the Chariot, which is connected with Cancer, and that which is yet not seen. You have the Nine of Cups, and the Cups is connected with water signs, Cancer, Pisces, or Scorpio, meaning you. So right now I'm thinking Cancer. He or she might have something in Cancer. Another way of reading this card is that you don't, by the time you meet him or her, what you don't, the thing that you're not aware of is that you're going to have good times with this person, and this person's going to have good times with you. And I'm talking about physically speaking, okay? At least, like, physically, this will be the person for you, and you're going to be very happy to be with him or her. This is also the card of wish fulfillment. You don't yet see that this person, your soulmate, is your wish fulfilled. That he's the dream, he or she is the dream that comes true. And you are in a very defensive type of place. I'm thinking it's more you, Scorpio, but it could be your soulmate. Your soulmate could be behaving like this. And the thing that is not seen for him or her is that you, Scorpio, you are his wish fulfilled or her wish fulfilled, okay? Also, you might meet him or her at a party, because this is the party time. Let's have a good time. You might meet him or her in a party. And I'm thinking flirty. The person, your soulmate, might be a bit flirty. Yeah, your person, your soulmate might be the life of the party. You might be like in a recuperating sort of mood. You are like recuperating from something. You are in a place that kind of emits the vibes of don't come near me, don't touch me, don't look at me. But your soulmate is the life of the party and emanates a sort of flirty energy and like kind of radiates energy and goodness towards everyone around him or her. Yeah, like sexy. He or she is sexy. So, yeah, like sexiness. And it's nice to be around him or her. It's just nice to be around this person. Okay? I'm thinking it's more your soulmate. I don't think it's you. I'm sorry to tell you. Okay? It could be you. Okay? It could be you. But I don't think it's you. It could be you. And you could have like a mix of Cancer and Scorpio. You can have the moon in Scorpio and the sun in Cancer. But I'm thinking it's more the other person. It's more your soulmate. Now, the root, the basis, the causes, you have, I'm sorry, you have the Queen of Cups, the Queen. So, the Queen of Cups is connected again with a water sign, Scorpio, like you, Cancer, or Pisces. This is an intuitive person, very intuitive person. If this relates to your soulmate, this person could be, if this relates to a person, it could be someone in her or his, because this is a very general reading, late 30s or after the age of 40. Someone who is intuitive, someone who walks into a room and just kind of reads everyone into the room intuitively. Someone who's psychic. Someone who might, you know, be very supportive to the ones he or she loves. A very supportive type of energy. Someone who loves unconditionally. Someone who's wise. But mainly I would say someone who's very intuitive. Because Scorpio, you're intuitive. So I'm thinking this relates more to you. Because this person seems not to be, you know, the queen. She seems to be, you know, don't look at me. She seems to be, again, in the type of demeanor, her type, the type of demeanor in this card, in this figure is, don't look at me, I don't want to connect with anyone, just shut up, leave me alone. I think it's this, you are in this sort of place. And you're not connecting with anyone because you want to, I'm sorry, you want to defend yourself and you want to be alone. Maybe in the past you suffered and you don't want to connect with anyone, and maybe you're forced to go into this sort of party and there's like this awesome man or woman who's the life of the party, and everyone, and he or she shines in this party, and you just don't want to be bothered. The reason for you to meet this person is to love unconditionally and to be loved unconditionally, and to also, for some of you, again, I'm sorry, I apologize. The reason is also might be to help you develop your intuition even further. That might be the reason for you to connect with this soulmate. If it's not you who needs to develop your psychic abilities or your insight, maybe it's the other person. Maybe the other person, your soulmate, needs to be a bit more compassionate. And maybe he or she is a bit self-centered. And when your soulmate meets you, he or she will develop a greater sense of compassion. Now, the past influencing the present and the future, you have the Four of Wands, which is interesting. Now, in traditional decks, the Four of Wands is connected with the Success card and the Marriage card. But I don't see that here. Do you see that here? I see a guy, a very good-looking dude. To me, this is a self-centered man. I look at this. To me, it feels like Apollo. Like he has the physique of a Greek god. And it feels like a guy who never had any type of bad things happening to him, and who has been always successful in his life, and this is the past. Now, you might just left a relationship with this sort of man. You might have been married or in a long-term relationship with this sort of man, someone who looked good, someone who's always successful, and someone who really thought highly of himself, because this is a very general reading, himself or herself, someone who's self-centered, and you're kind of sick of that. And the other person, the next person, your soulmate, it will allow you to actually feel to be in a relationship where true unconditional love will be present. And so far, maybe you were not in that type of relationship. You were in a relationship which was considered to be really successful, maybe married to a very successful man or woman, but this person is self-centered and truly never gave you unconditional love. And lots and lots of selfishness. Also, I'm connecting with the color red. This person might have had anger issues, a lot of rage. Okay, a lot of rage. So you're kind of sick of this. And you don't want anyone to come near you, Scorpio, by the time when you meet this person. Now, that which is in your mind or that which you want, you have the Six of Wands. Six of Wands, and I'm seeing here, what do I see? Two dragons. Actually, it's two people, and they are riding dragons, and they're battling out. They're fighting. So, Six of Wands traditionally is connected with it's a card of victory. So, these two people are battling, and one of them will be victorious. Again, I'm going back to you, Scorpio, who maybe in the past, now this could already have happened, or this will be happening at the time when you'll meet your soulmate. So, let's say that you were just married and everything is fine. And you're seeing this reading. And this reading absolutely does not connect with you at all. It maybe makes sense to you, I don't know, in 5 years, in 4 years, in 10 years, but at the time when you're meeting your soulmate, you are leaving, I would say, a relationship with a person who might have anger issues, someone who was very successful, very proud of himself or herself. Very self-centered, even a narcissistic type of guy, and you are fighting with this person. You are fighting with him or her, I don't know, for the house, for the right to divorce. I don't know if you have kids with him or her. I would say maybe, perhaps no, but it could be that as well. But you're fighting, and that which is in your mind is to be absolutely victorious in this fighting. And both of you have equal type of force, okay? Because these are two dragons. And it's like an ongoing battle, ongoing fight, and you want to be victorious. Okay? Another way of reading this, that which is in your mind is to travel, to leave. You want to leave this relationship, which is a bad relationship. You want to leave. You want to move to another city, even to another country. I would say maybe another city. You just want to leave and move, and this is what mainly is in your mind. And you are in a battle defense move, and don't attack me, I will cut you. There's like bad stuff going on, and you're sick of it. There's no time for you to devote to a new person. You don't have the energy when this person shows up. Now, the near future, it could be the time when you meet him or her, and again, I cannot give you timing. This could be 10 years from now, 3 years from now, I don't know. Or the time when you recognize your soulmate as your soulmate and you have the Judgment card. In here, what is it? In here, it's a figure. It's flying, like a dark figure. Usually, the Judgment card has to do with a complete transformation of your life. The Judgment card is connected with the planet Pluto. So, In the mists of a very significant Pluto transit, Scorpio, plus Pluto is your ruling planet, while you are suffering, and the word would be suffering, from a Pluto transit, this very significant Pluto transit, to your sun, to your moon, to your, so let's say you have the moon in Scorpio and you have Pluto in Capricorn, because Pluto right now is transiting Capricorn. You could have, for instance, the moon in Scorpio and the sun in Capricorn. So that would apply. And it doesn't leave, Pluto doesn't leave Capricorn in a few, I think it's 2024, if I'm not mistaken. So, during a time when you have a very significant Pluto transit to your sun, to your moon, to your rising sign, or to your Venus, this is the time when you might meet your soulmate. For instance, you might have the sun in Scorpio and you might have your Venus in Aquarius, for instance. And in a few more years, Pluto will be transiting Aquarius, for instance. This could apply. But at the time, and this is when I say transit, could be conjuncting, opposing, doing a square. I'm thinking it's more an opposition in a square, but it could be a conjunction also. But whatever planet this Pluto is going to touch, your planet, that planet in your natal chart, might be in a not very good condition. So it's while you are in the midst of this big transformation, while you are in the midst of a very significant Pluto transit, either to your sun, moon, rising sign, or Venus, this is the time when you meet your soulmate, or this is the time when you recognize your soulmate as your soulmate. So there's some sort of big transformation when you get out of this transformation, and I'm thinking it is connected with a former relationship that is not going well. When you are getting out, when you're about to move on, this is the time that you meet him or her. Another way of reading these cards, all these cards, is, let's say you are not in a relationship with anyone at the time when you meet your soulmate. You might be a very successful person, okay? You might have achieved a lot, a great success. You might look good, Scorpio. It doesn't matter if you're a man or a woman. You might have anger issues, some sort of rage, deep down rage. And you might not be a very type of compassionate person. You might not have a lot of compassion for others. You might have a lot of money. And you might have the type of attitude where you feel that you must battle everyone. You might be very competitive in terms of business. So maybe this competitiveness is connected with your business. Okay? And you're defending yourself because everything that you do goes fully to your business. You feel accomplished in your business. You feel like a very successful man or woman. And you have no compassion for others because you feel that maybe, perhaps, again, this is very general. Please don't sue me. Please don't be offended. You might feel that, if another people wanted to be as successful as I am, they'll work for it. So you might not be a very compassionate sort of person. And this person, your soulmate, comes in to change that. So it depends from case to case. So it could actually be like in the middle of a victory, in the middle of a very hard-won victory. This is when you meet your soulmate, and I would say in a party. A party you don't want to go to, okay? Even if it's your party, even if you're celebrating something which demanded from you a hard battle, you don't want to be there. And suddenly there's this person, there's this fantastic person, Who's the life of the party? Okay. Now. Also, this person will. Either it's like you're transforming yourself in the middle of this big transformation. This is when you meet him or her. And this person also signifies a transformation in your life. It signifies a call to destiny. He or she is your call to destiny. I don't know if this makes any type of sense to you. Now, the next card represents you, or it symbolizes you, Scorpio, and you have the Temperance card, which is connected with the sign of Sagittarius. Temperance speaks of moderation. So it feels like in the past, you might have had some anger issues, anger issues, but now you are like healing. You are in a place of healing. You are in a place of moderation. Like your temperament, you're much more mellowed out. What else? This is a mermaid. Interesting. So, Scorpio, you are much more like a moderate sort of person. You might have some sort of discipline. I'm thinking something to do with alcohol. Maybe some of you Scorpios kind of drank too much and you had to, you know, leave the drinking. So this card tells me that maybe you meet him or her around the time where you decide never to drink again, when you decide to make some sort of transformation in your life for health reasons. You decide you're in therapy. You know, maybe you drink too much and maybe you behave in a bad way when you drink too much. And when you decide to change that, to end that, when you decide to no longer drink, or you decide to deal with possible anger issues by going to therapy, this is the time when you meet him or her. When you will be much more, even though there's like a very big vibe of don't touch me, don't come near me, don't look at me, even though there's like that, you have that, part of you is healing, part of you it's much more pleasant than the outside facade, let's call it. So you might have like this sort of facade, but inside you're nicer. You're nicer than you look. Or you are nicer now because you're healing, because you gave up something that was bad for you. Now, those around you, or how other people see you, this might also relate to your soulmate. You have the Sun card. So, if this relates to your soulmate, he or she is the life of the party. Everyone looks at him or her. He or she might have something in Leo, because the Sun, I connected with Leo. For some, this person might even be notorious or famous, you know. Could even be a model. Someone beautiful. Someone who looks good. Someone who feels good to be around him or her. Because this person just radiates good, pleasant energy. Now, if this card relates to you, how other people see you, again, I have this sense of other people see you as successful, yes. As notorious, yes. But selfish. Because the Sun card also relates to being selfish. And, you know, other people might even see you, might even look at you as a bit narcissistic. But there's like a very good core inside of you. There's goodness. But you don't let it out in play, I would say, Scorpio. If this card relates to how other people see both of you, they will see both of you as the perfect couple. They will see both of you as like a notorious couple. Also, after you meet this soulmate, after you are with him or her, people will look at you, Scorpio, as someone really happy. they will look at you and they'll think, oh, this person really makes Scorpio happy. This man makes Scorpio happy. This woman makes Scorpio happy. So they will see you as a very happy person because you are with this new person. Now, hopes, fears, desires, advice, you have the Ace of Pentacles. You might want to settle down with this person. You might want to marry her or him. This is your wish, I would say. You want to actually build a life with this person. And for some of you, for many Scorpios, maybe this type of wish, you never had it before. You never had this type of desire of, you know, it depends, you know, from case to case. Some of you might have been married before, or you might have been with someone but not actually married. But for others, maybe this is like the first time that you meet someone with whom you really want to have a life, and this is your wish, your desire. The advice is that do not take this relationship lightly. Actually build a foundation with this person. This is for real, okay? This would be the advice. Build a life with him or her. As a fear, I would say that you're afraid that this person takes you away from your business, because already you had some sort of victory and you're already thinking about a new type of business. There's like something already in your mind by the time you meet your soulmate, and you're afraid that your soulmate will take time and energy away from your business, from expanding your business, from thinking up new businesses. Okay, now the outcome, you have the Chariot card, which is a successful card. So this could be a very successful type of relationship. This is even, you know, physically speaking, this is a successful relationship. This might even entail you moving, I don't know, to another city, even to another country. I would say maybe perhaps to another city in order to be with this person. Or this person moves to a city where you live in order to be with you. But this card tells me this is a very successful type of relationship. As long as both of you have the same goals. Having the same goals, it will be very important. And if you can't, you know, unite your goals, or at least one important goal that both of you have, this has the potential of being a very successful relationship. Now, remember the cards that I've shown you: Letter, Rider, and Child. Pick one if you have not. If you pick the card Child, this means that this reading is relevant for you between 80 and 90%. If you have picked the card Letter, it means that this reading is relevant for you between 40 and 50%. If you have picked the card Rider, this means that between 10 and 20% of this reading is relevant for you. And that's it. Scorpio, this is the reading that I have. If you like something personal, please write to duniaazad@gmail.com, and I'd be delighted to work with you. Bye-bye.